Hey everyone, Ariel Adams here with the Blog to Watch. Please subscribe to our videos on YouTube and like this video if you find it useful. Also hit the bell to be notified of our upcoming videos. This is a review of the Andersmann Bronze 1000M or 1000 meter. This is a 1000 meter water resistant watch that's now in bronze, the first for Andersmann. This is, I think, the third watch from the brand I've reviewed. They've had, five or six models out now. This is a brand that I really admire because what they do is they began with someone who was a Panerai collector. And for whatever reason, he wanted to be a watch brand entrepreneur. So he said, let me take what I like about Panerai and change it a little bit for me. And so you have the sort of large sport watch, minimalist dial, not really minimalist, but simple dial. But this one's a lot more modern, right? This is a lot more modern looking than you would expect sort of your normal Panerai to be. And these are actually a lot more water resistant. So 1,000 meters is considered not very water resistant for the brand. You know, I think the first watch of theirs that I reviewed was water resistant 3,000 meters. Doesn't matter. No one's going down that deep. But it's definitely something that, you know, watch nerds like to talk about. Like, oh, your watch only goes down to 300 meters? Well, mine's 500 meters, 600 meters, 1,000. Obviously goes up from there. There's exotic ones that are way more water resistant. And it looks it too, right? It's a very thick watch. It's got thick sapphire crystal. I like that the crown here is put at the 4 o'clock position so that it doesn't jam into your wrist. This bronze watch has been patina-ing in the air for a couple of months now. So it's not too patinaed, but you can start to see some of that tarnishing which occurs on bronze. And you can actually wipe that off with the solution. And there's kind of interesting ways of having it be patinaed and unpatinaed and things like that, which is kind of neat. Bronze is still a fun material. I still think I prefer steel, but the color and personality of bronze is very real. There's three different versions, at least of right now, of the Andersmann Bronze 1000. And the difference between the two is the dial and some of the coloration. So you can see here the blue seconds hand. And the dial is sort of a brushed metal. It's kind of an interesting texture, but I like a lot. And the different versions of the watch, they're just slightly different. Not radically different. I don't know how you would choose one or another, but they're just slightly different. And I really like that there's that built-in sense of having different flavors. It means that Andersmann themselves, when they were coming up with, they just couldn't decide. Well, which one do we like? We don't know. We're going to try all of them. Let's turn the rotating bezel here. It's a little on the quieter side, but you definitely have a nice clicking action to it. A big lume pip in the bezel there. A lot of good lume in this watch. You can definitely enjoy the lume. And one of the things that this dial has, similar to other Andersmann watches, is it's what's called a sandwich construction. And so if you look very closely there, the hour markers are actually cutouts, and there's a layer of luminant underneath them, and the upper dial is placed on there like a plate with holes in it, with like stencil holes, and that's why it's called a sandwich dial. It's literally a sandwich with multiple layers. So let's put the watch on the wrist. Again, at 44 millimeters wide, this is of the smaller Andersmann watches. They actually go bigger than that. When you buy the watch, it comes in a nice kit with a couple of straps. This is sort of the taupe-colored brown rubber strap that goes quite well with the dial. It's a little bit large for my wrist, but it's comfortable. And I don't have any other straps this color, so if I put something else in there, it wouldn't match the dial nearly as well as this, again, taupe strap to match that dial. So once again, this is I forgot to talk about the movement. How dare I? The movement inside this watch is an ETA 2892-2 automatic, and I didn't actually recall showing you how, even though this is a 1,000-meter water-resistant watch, it also has a display caseback. Look how nice that is. And you can see the movement there. The crystal on the back of the case is a little bit tinted. It's just, I'm gonna give a little bit of a wipe there. Slightly darkened, so it just gives it a little bit of a personality, but I think that's a nice presentation of the movement. Again, especially in a 1,000-meter water-resistant watch, something which is very uncommon, definitely on the rare side to see a movement through the case like that. So again, this is the Andersmann Bronze 1000M. It's part of a long line of interesting watches at Andersmann. It's still a young brand, but they're definitely doing a lot of cool things. Don't forget that this 44 millimeter wide case is 16 millimeters thick, Wears fun. Really enjoy it. Price is $1,888. And you can see the full review on aBlogtoWatch. Thanks.